Hi everyone, this is Sherry from Planning Peep and welcome back to my channel. Today I have another memory spread for you guys and it's going to be for the week of May 13th through May 19th. And before I jump into the kit that I'm going to be using for this spread, I just want to let you guys know that my summer plans have kind of changed, so I may not be able to film and upload as many videos as I was hoping to. My parents are coming to stay with us for a couple months this summer. So I'm going to be spending a lot of time with them that I just wasn't anticipating before. So that may just kind of throw off my video schedule, but you guys have always been so understanding of just the fact that personal life gets in the way, and I really, really appreciate your continued support. So without further ado, I'm going to jump right into the kit that I'm going to use this week. This is from Avenue K Design, and it's called Terracotta. I did just share this in a recent haul video, but if you missed that, I'm going to really quickly go over what's included in the kit. I did pick up these sheets a la carte, so I only grabbed the ones that I felt like I needed, and so that's why you're not seeing the full kit, but she does offer more pages beyond what I'm using today. So it comes with a little sampler that matches the kit, which is perfect. So it has a lot of little functional items and some deco pieces, which is lovely. Angela, who is the owner of the shop, created this little extra freebie for me, and it's so cute because she customized it to have these little IEP flags, because she's watched my videos before and she knows that I always mark my meetings using these little flags. So she made them to match the kit, and that was so thoughtful of her. And for this kit, it is gold foiled, as you can see. It's super pretty and all the boxes are foiled. This one that I got does have some little imperfections that you might see kind of here and there in the kit, but I contacted the owner and she did say that for this one she had to use a different foiling, and she's since switched back to her original one, which is a lot better and doesn't come off in some of the spots. So that's definitely not an issue moving forward, and I don't really mind too much if there's like foiling imperfections, just because I know it happens and it's not something that's really noticeable. So here we've got the full boxes. On this page, we have the bottom washi, which is super pretty. We've got some washi strips and date covers. Here we have the half boxes, some scallop labels, quarter boxes, and three heart checklists. And the last page I picked up has all the functional items. So we have heart check flags. We have these little time dots, which is perfect for marking meetings. We've got some flags, some deco, a weekend banner, some circle icons, these really pretty bow paperclip stickers, and then some text stickers in the center. So it definitely comes with quite a lot, despite only being four sheets. And with these two extra little freebies, I definitely think I'll have plenty to work with. So anyways, I know this intro is getting kind of long, so I'm gonna go ahead and get started. And as usual, I'm gonna place down my bottom washi first. I don't think I mentioned it earlier, but this kit came with two different washi strips. So I placed down the thinner strip at the top and then layered the thicker strip underneath that. And the thicker one is the one that has the gold foiling and also has a white background. So I decided to white out the lines of my Erin Condren just so they didn't peek through the washi. After I finished placing down my washi, I moved to the sidebar and placed down the quote box in the top corner. And because that quote box has like a white background, I decided to add a little bit of deco just to spice it up a little bit. So I placed down a couple green, like leafy pieces of deco in the corners, and I really, really like how that turned out. And then moving to my date covers, I did use the date covers that came with the kit, and I found some date dots. I think these are from Paper Blush Bar. I am slowly running out of the date dots, so I really have to purchase more of those. I don't really have any like full weeks left. I kind of just have random numbers here and there, so I definitely need to get on that. And then once I'm done with that, I continue with my sidebar as usual. I placed down one of those washi strips with the gold foiled sprinkles, which I think is so pretty. And then I used a habit tracker that I think is from the kit or from a sampler sheet that I got, and I just thought that matched really well. The sampler sheet I got from Avenue K Design came with this workout script sticker, and so I put that down to mark my workouts instead of writing it in myself. And then I placed down a third box to mark my happy moments. And because there was only one Monday through Sunday box, I decided to pull in a heart checklist, which was actually perfect because it came with seven hearts. I put down another third box at the bottom to track my dinners, and I used the Monday through Sunday box for that. And instead of pulling in icons, I decided to use deco for the little third boxes this week. I covered up the flag of my Erin Condren with a flag that came in the kit, and then I moved to Monday. So first I put down a washi strip and I wrote today over that, and then I used one of the scallop labels from the kit with a pen sticker from Planning Like a Pro to mark that I had a morning testing appointment with a student, and then I stopped by to grab some coffee and a bagel sandwich before I headed to my other school. That coffee sticker is from my spoiled planner. I then put down this gold foil like arrow sticker, I think that's from Magic Prince Co., to mark that I got to my other site, and then I used a half box with the IEP flags that came in the little sampler to mark an IEP meeting that I had that afternoon. When I got home, I actually went on a run that day and also did like a 20-minute strength training workout. So I was really proud of myself for doing all that. And I put that on a quarter box with a shoe sticker from Paper and Milk. And then later that night, it was super dumb, but my boyfriend and I got into this huge fight, literally over something really stupid. So I just wanted to mark that because we were just like so upset at each other for a while. And that Angry Girl sticker is from Art Box Stickers. I then put down a full box at the bottom, and it is like empty in the middle, so I was able to write something inside. And so I just marked that I did some retail therapy at Marshall's that night. I think I got like a couple new shirts and like a new maxi dress, so you know, there was something good that came out of that whole situation. But anyways, it really wasn't a big deal, and you know, everything's fine. So then moving to Tuesday, I first started by putting down a full box at the top, and then I used another washi strip with a remembered gold foiled sticker from Rose Color Days just as a header and to bring in some more gold foil. I put down one of those like time flag stickers to mark a meeting that I had. And then I had another IEP that afternoon, so I used a half box with another flag that came in the little sampler sheet. That IEP we had was definitely a more high profile case, and so I was honestly so relieved when it was over and everything went well. So I used a quarter box with a Happy Munchkin from Once More With Love to mark how I felt after that was over. And then I marked that I forgot my laptop at work, so I had to double back to grab it, which was really annoying because I was like already on the freeway. That laptop sticker is from Magic Prince Co. And then at the end of the night, I had a couple reports to write for the following day, so I put that on a half box at the bottom, and initially I used a laptop sticker from Hazel Sticker, but I did end up switching it out for this little girl on a laptop sticker from Paper Bear Co. Those are new in my collection. I really wanted to use it, so that's why I switched it out. And then I just marked that we had tacos for dinner that night, and the taco sticker is from Plans with Vanessa. On Wednesday, I first started by placing down a flag, and I just put hump day on top because that's something I mark when I don't have a lot going on a Wednesday and I want to do something to take up more space. And underneath that, I put down a washi strip with an important script sticker from the kit to mark that we had a staff meeting that morning. And I put that on a gold foiled quarter box, which is so pretty. And then we had another really big IEP that day, so I used another IEP flag from my sampler sheet to mark that. I then put down a full box underneath that, and then I used a, I think it's a strip of washi with a cardio sticker from MJ and Hope over that to mark that I did some cardio when I got home that night. And then I used a half box with a gold foiled sticker from Clever Gal Crafts to mark that we did our date night on Wednesday this week. At the very bottom, I initially put down a YouTube emoji from the Coffee Monsters Co. and a gold foiled film sticker from Magic Prince Co., but I ended up replacing the emoji sticker with a film clapper from Mandy Dreams instead. Moving to Thursday, I first started by placing down a washi strip at the top with another remember header from Rose Color Days, and Thursday was actually a rainy day, and it's so crazy because we're like in the middle of May and still getting rain in Southern California. I can't remember the last time that we've gotten rain this late in the year, but it's really nice because we definitely need the water, and that little rainy cloud sticker is from Whimsical Cat Studio. I then put down a quarter box with a bow paper clip sticker from the kit, but I decided to outline it a little bit because it was hard to see against the quarter box, and I used that to mark a testing appointment that I had that day. I then had three meetings that afternoon, so instead of marking them all separately, I just used a three-heart checklist with a gold foiled meeting sticker from Hazel Sticker and just consolidated all of the meetings onto the one checkbox. That evening, I went to happy hour with a couple of my girlfriends, and which is why we had to do date night on Wednesday instead. But yeah, it was really good to see them and hang out. So I pulled in the happy hour script sticker from Paper and Milk, and then the beer sticker is from Dizzy Daisy Dreams. I then put down another full box and pulled in a gold foiled film sticker from Magic Prince Co. again to mark that I filmed when I got home, and then I read Harry Potter for the rest of the night, and that book sticker is from Paper and Milk. On Friday, I first put down a full box at the bottom because I knew that's where I wanted it. And then moving to the top, I put down a quarter box with the gold foil, which is so cute. And then I pulled in a gold foiled bow from Clever Gal Crafts with the Fryade text sticker that came in the kit. I used another one of those time stamp flags to mark a meeting that I had in the morning, and I went off campus to grab some boba really quick that day, so I pulled in this cute boba sticker, I think it's from Paper Bear Co., to mark that, and then I put down a half box with the last IEP flag from the sampler sheet to mark an IEP that afternoon, and then I placed down a washi strip with a sushi date sticker from Love Shira to mark that my boyfriend and I went and got some sushi for dinner that night. I then put down a 3-heart checklist to mark the things I did that afternoon, and I had recently gotten these gold foiled like checklist bows from Chic Blossom Prints, and I really wanted to pull them in, so I decided to just place it over the hearts, and I think that turned out really well. And I used that checklist just to mark the things that I did when I got home that night, and that gold foiled TV sticker is from Magic Prints Co. For the weekend, as usual, I start by placing down the weekend banner at the top, and then I pulled in this half box with a beauty sleep sticker, and unfortunately, I don't know where that one is because I found it in my leftover stash. And then I used a flag with a money icon from, I think it's from the Sparkly Studio, to mark that we had to pay our gardeners that day, and then we went and got some lunch and gelato with some of our friends, so I marked that with the half box and a gold foiled bow from Clever Gal Crafts. After that, we went to a few breweries and just kind of hung out for the rest of the night and also had some dinner at one of the breweries. So the beer sticker that I pulled in is from Dizzy Daisy Dreams. And at one of the breweries, they had mead, which is very dangerous, but very tasty. And so I definitely wanted to mark that because it's not something I have very often. That little wine glass sticker is from Sunset Sticker Co. And then at the end of the night, when I got home, I did do some editing. So I pulled in some gold foiled stickers from Magic Prints Co. to mark that. For Sunday, I started by placing down the full box at the top, and then I used another cute rain cloud sticker from Whimsical Cat Studio to mark that it rained again on Sunday. And initially, I marked that I went to check my P.O. box, but later I realized that I had so many things to mark that day because we did a ton of errands, and I did not have enough space to include everything, so I ended up lifting that up and using a heart checklist instead to mark all of the things that I did. And then to create a header, I just put down a washi strip and pulled in the priorities text sticker from the kit. I replaced that Happy Mail icon from Magic Prints Co. because we did go check my P.O. box. And that day we went over to a friend's house and we did a Game of Thrones marathon. So that was actually the day that the series finale was coming out. And so we went earlier in the day and just watched like all of the 5 episodes before and then watched the last one when it came out. So it actually was really fun. I don't really watch Game of Thrones. Like I kind of know what happens, but I don't watch like religiously. So I was just kind of there watching intermittently. I actually was able to get a lot of editing done, which was awesome. And that popcorn sticker is from my spoiled planner. That's pretty much all we did that day. And so to fill up that last little space, I just used a quarter box with a bow sticker. I think that's from the kit to mark that I recorded my voiceover and did the editing while we were watching Game of Thrones. So that is it for my week. And as usual, I finished out the spread by filling in my sidebar. And what I've been doing lately is filling it out day by day rather than section by section. And I think that actually goes faster for me. And then I'm just placing down a few deco pieces throughout the spread. I don't have a lot of empty space, but there was so much deco that came in the kit, I wanted to use it. And now I'm just showing you these stickers that I have left in the kit and also doing a really quick Viv Wiggle to show you guys all of the gold foil. And yeah, that is it for my spread today, you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this. This kit was honestly so fun to pull in because there were so many functional stickers. And so I actually pulled in very little from my collection. Everything I needed pretty much came in the kit. So that was really awesome. And if you're interested in checking out this shop, I do have a coupon code. So that is down below. I can't remember off the top of my head what it is, so definitely check my description box if you would like to check out her shop. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Thank you for bearing with me as I kind of slowly get through these videos. I really enjoy making these videos, but I just don't always have a lot of time or energy to get to them. So anyways, I appreciate the support. And yeah, that's it for today. So I will talk to you guys next time. Bye.